Alright, Article 246, 7th schedule. This article will tell you who is having what power, okay? Because there are power is divided by between central government and state government, that is parliament and state legislative assembly. So who is authorized to make which types of law? So income tax is a central law, everybody knows that. I have taught you that particular act. It is central level law or state level law? Hello, income tax is Income Tax Act India or Income Tax Act Maharashtra? India. Why? Because entry number 82 says that it is power given to central government. Okay, so please understand, Article 246 has 7 schedule. 7 schedule is having 3 lists. List 1, list 2 and list 3. List 1 has the name union list. List 2 has name state list. And list 3 has name concurrent list. Okay. In list 1, central government has exclusive power. When I say exclusive, you should understand this word. I had taught you this word in PGBP. Exclusive means exclusive. Nobody can interfere in that. Okay. So central government has exclusive power to what? To enact a law on taxes of income. By using this power, they had introduced Income Tax Act 1961, that you everybody know. But Income Tax Act can be on all types of income excluding agriculture income. Please understand why agriculture income is excluded from entry number 82, because to levy tax on agriculture income, this power is given in entry number 46 under state list. So even it's not that in India there cannot be agriculture taxation. There can be agriculture taxation, but that call has to taken by state government, not by central government. Central government does not have any power to tax agriculture income. So state government is having power to tax agriculture income. Alright, sir, entry number 83 is about customs act. You already know import and export will be charged by, so goods are importing to Mumbai port now. You understand? So technically it is imported in Maharashtra, but who will collect custom duty? Maharashtra government or central government? Why central government? Because this is a central law. This is a central law. Sir, how do you come to know about it? Because it is written in list 1. Anything which is written in list 1 is a central law. Okay. Now many people believe that excise was deleted after GST. When they introduced GST, we believe that excise is deleted because excise is one of the major central law which has merged with GST. I'm telling you, central excise law has not been deleted. Majority item which were covered by central excise law has been deleted and they are merged with GST. Okay, but still central GST is there on manufacturing. GST, this particular excise law is there on manufacturing. Manufacturing of what, sir? Petroleum crude, high speed diesel, motor, spirit, which is commonly known as petrol, alright, natural gas, and aviation turbine fuel. What is aviation turbine fuel, sir? For aircraft, you cannot put normal diesel and petrol. It requires high power. That is ATF, aviation turbine fuel. And last item you can see, tobacco and tobacco product. So on these many items, even after introduction of GST, still excise is continued. So excise building will be there, excise officers will be there, but they are having limited product now. These are the product on which excise can be levied today. Okay? Yes. Excise cannot be levied, please understand. Central excise cannot be levied on Indian hemp, okay? These are drugs, okay? OPM, drugs, chorus, ganja. You must have heard in Hindi. So they are Indian hemp, OPM, narcotics. Any narcotic product on that central government does not have power to levy tax. So far as alcoholic liquor for human consumption is also not given to central government. Okay. So when you see division of power, tobacco has kept by central government and liquor has been kept by state government. So if I'm manufacturing tobacco, please understand, I'm manufacturing tobacco, gutka, cigarette, BD, whatever you say, any tobacco product, who is having right to collect excise duty from me? Central government. But if I am manufacturing drugs, OPM, narcotics, alcoholic liquor for human consumption, ALHS, HC means alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Here I have written, alcoholic liquor for? So this particular, on this 3-4 item, who will collect GST law? State. Please understand, alcohol and drugs are with state. Tobacco is with? Central. Okay, this is how you have to keep in your mind. And petroleum manufacturing is with central. Okay, petroleum and tobacco with central, alcohol and drugs with state. On manufacturing, please understand, there is a state excise and there is a central excise. Both government are charging tax. Please understand, both government are charging excise, and that's why when we write here, we haven't write excise act, we have written central excise act. See, we have not written central customs act. Why? Because there is only one act, central only, no need to mention. We don't have central income tax. Why? Because there is only one act. But there are multiple acts so far as excise is concerned. Excise is there in central level, excise is there in state level. State government will give state name, Maharashtra Excise Act, okay? But central government has given central name, okay? So whenever you see central as a word in any particular act, please understand that act is even existed on state level. That's why to make a difference, they put central in as a word in name of the act, okay? Similarly, we are having central sales tax. Similarly, we are having? That means sales tax will be there on state level also. State level sales tax was known as, please understand, state level was known as VAT. VAT means value added tax. Now we don't have to speak more about value added tax because it is abolished. Abolished means it has merged with GST. But still, even today, these are the products which are covered under VAT law. So VAT is also not 100% deleted. Okay, all these five items, if manufactured, who will take tax? Central. But when you sell it, who will take tax? Hello? There are two events, manufacturing and sale. When I manufacturer, manufacturing, who will take tax? Central. But when I am selling, who will take tax? State. Please understand. When I am manufacturing alcohol, who is taking tax? State. And when I am selling alcohol, who is taking tax? State. So alcoholic liquor for human consumption, manufacturing is also with state and sale is also with state. Hello? Yeah? But petroleum, manufacturing is with central and sale is with state. That means on this five product, please understand, on this five product, central is taking excise and state is taking VAT. Hello? Central is taking excise and state is taking VAT. And when state takes VAT, that includes excise duty. So if I charge, please understand, if this price of this product is 1000 rupees and if you add 10% excise duty, it will become 1100. When they have to charge VAT 10%, they will not charge on 10%. They will not charge on 1000 rupees. They will charge on 1100 rupees. That means VAT is a tax on excise. Hello, VAT is tax on value as well as VAT is tax on excise. This is a double taxation. This is not cascading. Cascading I will teach you later. This is double taxation. On same product, there are two taxes levied. Central excise as well as state VAT. This is a problem. Not only that, when it is entered from one municipal authority to another municipality, they will charge entry tax. Third tax on petrol. Or any product for that matter. Please understand. And this is the reason why petrol is so costly in India. Rahul Gandhi and many Congress people are abusing BJP for not reducing prices of petrol. Why they cannot reduce prices? Petrol prices cannot be controlled by BJP and any government for that matter. But they can control what? Tax rates? Hello? And because it is not in GST, there is still this problem. If it comes in GST, there will be only one tax. GST, but right now it is outside the GST because neither central is ready to leave their manufacturing on this product nor state is ready to leave their VAT on this product. They are happy in collecting excise and they are happy in collecting VAT because this is the product, no matter whether economy is going up, down or normal, constant, this product will be consumed irrespective of economic position and your level of income. And you can assume that this, all products which are on my board, okay, petrol, liquor, tobacco, drugs, these are continuously consumed commodities no matter how much price rise you bring in that. So cigarette, if goes from 20 to 22 rupees, it does not mean that people who are smoking cigarette, they will stop smoking it. Okay, alcohol price was earlier 150 rupees, now it has become 160 rupees. That will not stop the consumption of the alcohol. Petrol price earlier was 70 rupees, now it is 78 rupees. That will not stop my consumption. Hello? And this is the reason why government is charging highest taxes on this particular product. These are the highest profitable products for the government. When government look at this particular product, they are highly profitable product. If you want to control tobacco consumption, a very simple solution is that you don't have to put ban on sale on paan patti, you understand? In this small shop, you just ban the company. You just ban the manufacturing entity. They will not do that. Why? Because ITC is giving them, Indian Tobacco Company, like this kind of company, they are giving them huge revenue, crores of rupees revenue. And who would like to cut their own pocket? Alright? I don't know whether I had spoken about this or not. Bars on highway.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's not allowed. You cannot have bars on highway. You can see when you cross this particular Dahisar Chek Naka of Mumbai exit, alright, the next highway is known as Mumbai Ahmedabad Highway. And Gujarat is a dry state. And Maharashtra is a wet state. It is legal to drink here, but it is illegal to drink in
Gujarat.
But it's not illegal to enter in Gujarat with a drink. So what people are doing before entering in Gujarat on highway, they are drinking unlimited, and then they enter in Gujarat because that state is a dry state. Okay, so on highway it is difficult to find medical, it is difficult to find general store, it is difficult to find normal food hotel. All things that you can see is bar, only bars and bars and bars. Okay, on highway you can observe this. Okay, when government passed that notification that somewhere 500 meter from highway you cannot have bar and restaurant. Okay, so this particular bars were suddenly shut down. Suddenly all bars on highway after this toll naka was closed. Okay, after 3-4 months they again opened it. All right, then I was riding with Anjesh and I asked Anjesh, like, that notification is withdrawn or what? Because I thought that law had, like, they had withdrawn the law, that notification of closure of bars. Anjesh told, no Ram, they had not withdrawn the notification. They had passed another notification, and that notification says this road is not a highway. Okay, earlier it was national highway. They passed notification, they said this much kilometer, some 15-20 kilometer highway is not a highway. This is under municipal corporation. This is a municipal, like this Shubhas Road, this is not highway. This is normal road. Here you can have bar and restaurant. Alright, so that highway which was actual highway, they passed a notification and said this is not a highway. Then when they were passing this particular notification, central government told them, if you say this is not highway, so from next year onwards, we will not repair this road. We will not maintain this road. Plantation, everything you have to take care of because it is your road now. This is not national highway. They said, okay, that we will handle. Don't worry about it. Okay, why this notification was passed that this is not a highway? Because now bars are again, but because technically now bars are not on highway, they are on normal road. But that is actually Mumbai Ahmedabad highway. This is the level of India. Okay, in India we are having corruption at this level. Okay, corruption, or you can see people who are having power, they can use their power. Okay, so these products, they are very important product for government. Please understand, although everyone is opposing to consume this, but nobody is stopping consumption. Nobody. Okay, because these are important revenue generating products. That is a simple reason. So then there is a central sales tax. Now I will tell you which tax, which laws are abolished. Okay, GST has not touched my income tax. Income tax was there, income tax is still there. Okay, custom was there, custom is still there. Some people are saying because of GST, one nation, one tax. Have you heard this wording? They are feeling that all taxes are gone and now only there is only one tax, which is GST. No Baba, income tax was there, income tax is still there. Okay, excise was there on all product. Now excise is still there on this product. Okay, apart from this, everything else is outside excise. Okay, sir, CST was there, now CST is not there. Okay, majority CST is deleted. So what is this residuary entry? Residuary entry means acts which are not covered under entry 1, acts which are not covered under list 1 and list 2, and which are neither covered under list 3. You can see in my list 3 there is no revenue law. Revenue law means there is no tax law. So tax laws are either in list 2, that means either we are having state level tax laws or we are having central level tax laws. Have you gone for movie?
Yes.
You know some movies which are very important, they make it a tax free movie.
Yes.
Like one of the movie was Miss Shivaji Raje Bhosle Bolte Hai. Yeah, it was tax free. I watch it in 30 rupees. Tax free, when it is tax free, it price goes to that level. There was one movie which has nominated for Oscar, Shwas. Local movie, I'm telling you, okay? So all these movies, and then Hindi movie, if I'm not wrong, I guess for Sultan or Dangal, I don't know. One of the movie was made, toward the end, it was made tax free. Alright, because they show some national level sport and everything. So some movies, the government make it tax free. Tax free means government will not take tax on that particular movie. So price will go directly less than half. Okay. So, sir, who is taking that tax? Central government? No. That tax is taken by your either local authority or state government. So, there was two types of entertainment tax. Entertainment tax charged by state government and entertainment charged by local authority. Entertainment tax charged by state government is deleted and merged with GST. But entertainment tax which is charged by your local authority is still there. So, entertainment tax per se is not deleted. We have to say very precisely, entertainment tax charged by state government is merged with GST. But entertainment tax by municipal corporation is still there in effect. So, today also municipal corporation, Mumbai municipal corporation can charge this particular tax. If there is circus tomorrow here, anything which is causing entertainment, like we are having water kingdom, alright, so still there will be one tax charged by our local authority. Okay. Taxes on advertisement was charged by state government, which is merged with GST. Sir, VAT, is it merged with GST? Yes. Everything of VAT has gone in GST except this product. Okay. Sir, what about state entry tax? Entry tax is deleted, it is gone in GST. Sir, what about state excise duty? All product of state excise duty is merged with GST except three. Come on, tell which three? Alcoholic liquor for human consumption, OPM and Indian hemp. Okay. So, all these acts are merging with GST. I will give you a detailed list for that. Sir, what is this residuary entry? Residuary entry means it is not in concurrent list, it is not in state list, and it is not there in any matter from entry number 1 to entry number 96. So, entry number 97 is a residuary. Residuary means any other matter. So, tax on any other matter. Who will bring tax on any matter which is not defined in constitution? Who will bring tax on that? So, central government will bring tax on that. One of this particular law was service tax. One of this particular law was entry number 97 had service tax. It is there or deleted? Deleted 100%. Deleted? And service tax is merged with GST. But security transaction tax, commodity transaction tax and banking transaction tax. Please understand these three tax. Security transaction tax, commodity transaction tax and banking transaction tax. These are very small tax. When you pay STT, whenever you deal in, come on, I have taught you in capital gain. Whenever you deal in share market, you have to pay STT. Whenever you deal in commodity market, you have to pay commodity transaction tax. And whenever you do some banking transaction beyond certain limit, alright, you have to pay banking transaction tax. So, these taxes in form of direct taxes are still there. Hello, they are direct taxes, they are still there. GST has not impacted this particular thing. GST has accumulated 17 types of indirect taxes. Hello, GST has accumulated 17 types of indirect taxes, not direct taxes. Direct taxes were there, they are still there. Excise was there, excise still there, but only on selected product. Okay, VAT was there, VAT still there, but only on selected product. People feel that VAT gaya, GST gaya, service tax gaya. No, it's not like that. It's not gaya gaya. It's still there. Huh, majorly gaya. 99.99% has been gone. But still it is alive. Okay. So this is precise understanding through constitution. Everything else we will read in chapters. But why it is written? So you will see in GST charging section, on this 5 items no GST charge. On this 5 items no GST charge. Now you know the logic first. What is the logic? Because on these 5 items, still excise duty is there. Hello? Yeah? So, write it down. Finished it. Pause it.